Hey, what's up, everybody? Another edition of OVW Mania here on Triple Threat Talk. I am Brian Cannon. This week I'm going to be talking about the latest edition of OVW TV, which was episode 726. Filmed at the Davis Arena Wednesday, July 17th, the night before TNA Impact Wrestling came to town. It was released the following day, of course, on OVWrestling.com and Blip.TV. I'll get into TNA Impact later because, of course, I went there with the Triple Threat Talk guys. It was a lot of fun. But first, going through the OVW television episode, it opened up with Jay Bradley coming out. He talked about Jamin Olivencia signing the contract last week and their match coming up at SNS, and he says that he knows why Jamin passed out. It's because he was scared of having to face someone twice his size, and he kept calling him Nacho Olivares once again. Jamin came out and he said that the contract that Jay Bradley was holding was phony, and said that he didn't agree to any of the stipulations, and that he knows it, Jay Bradley knows it, all the fans know it. And he said that he brought someone in to help litigate the contract, and he brought out TNA Impact star Joseph Park. Joseph came to the ring and said that, as he read through it, he said, "Wait a second, it says if Jamin gets disqualified, you automatically win the title. If you get counted out, you automatically win the title." And then it also had a thing in there about getting timeouts anytime he pleased. And Jay Bradley said, "Well, yeah, I'm a big guy. I've got to stay hydrated." And Joseph Park said, "No, this isn't a contract that's worth anything." And he tears it up. And Jay Bradley tells Jamin, he goes, "Well, you had to get somebody big to fight your battles for you." He goes, "You know, I could beat you all if I had a partner for myself." And as he's saying that, Marcus Anthony makes his way out to the ring and joins Jay Bradley's side, and Jay says, "Well, I guess I've made a friend, and I guess I'll see you all in the ring tonight." So that set up the main event for the evening. Jay Bradley teamed with Marcus Anthony to take on Jamin Olivencia and Joseph Park. Later on, Shiloh Jones of the Marauders, who's kind of became the leader, so even having Flash with them, has kind of stepped up and taken charge of the new group. He fought in singles action, defeating newcomer Yaden Matthews. There was a bunch of backstage scenes throughout the night where Jesse Godders was changing in the restroom as part of his punishment. We didn't know exactly what he was changing into, but they showed a bunch of wrestlers keep going in there and laughing and pointing at him. Next up, TNA Knockout and Knockout referee ODB came out. She talked about how she started basically the women's division in OVW. She was the first ever OVW women's champion, where she won the title in a tournament in Rio de Janeiro. She talks about being arrested at a Six Flags Kentucky Kingdom show. She talks about how she got to wrestle with the likes of Beth Phoenix, Serena, Katie Lee, Alicia Fox, Kelly Kelly, just to name a few. She said that tonight she felt like getting physical and wanted the toughest woman in the locker room to come out. So the current OVW Women's Champion, Trina, made her way out and said that she was the toughest. And then Lady Tapa came out and said that no, she was. And they had an argument. It was kind of funny. ODB looked up at Lady Tapa and said, "Don't eat me." ODB came up with the idea, "How about we have a three-way to find out who the toughest is," which Lady Top ended up picking up the win. She got the pin over Trina after hitting her with a big boot, which would lead me to believe that at the next SNS we'll probably see a title match for the OVW Women's Championship between Trina and Lady Tapa. Earlier in the night, there was also a backstage scene where Randy Royal said that he wanted Rudy to give up his shot for the OVW television title against Dylan Bostic later in the night, which Rudy refused to do. And Royal said, "We can either do this the easy way or the hard way." And Rudy said, "You can do it any way you choose." He goes, "But I'm going out there and taking my title shot." So that match happens. Rudy ends up beating Dylan Bostic by disqualification because, naturally, Randy Royal came out and attacked Rudy's switchblade. Tony Gunn then came out with a sling on one arm and tried fighting Randy Royal off. But Royal ended up getting the better of him and throwing him into the barricade wall twice. Then Tony had to be helped to the back. Next up, Dean Hill got in the ring, and it was time for Jesse Goddard's punishment. He didn't seem like he wanted to come out. The curtain shook a lot before he finally made his way out in a pink bunny suit. And he said that he's not a loser, and he kept telling Dean Hill he hated him, and this is all his fault. And Dean told him that he has to wear that pink bunny suit until he wins another match. He said he could end up getting rid of the bunny suit as early as tonight because he had a match coming up next. He said, but he said, if you take that suit off before you win a match, he goes, you will be fined, fired, and you will lose your TNA contract. And then Jesse's opponent is a newcomer Australian named Jack Dundee. And it was basically a squash. Dundee beat him. Great-looking moonsault off the top rope to finish Jesse off. So the newcomer, Jack Dundee, gets the win, which means Jesse still has to keep wearing the bunny suit. And then in the main event, Jay Bradley, Marcus Anthony beat Joseph Park and Jamin Olivencia. Marcus actually had the win. He hit Jamin with the Gamma Punch. And at the two count, Jay Bradley pulled Marcus out of the ring because he didn't want Marcus to get the win. They kind of push and shove each other, and Marcus ends up getting out of the ring. Jay ends up connecting with the boomstick on Jamin and getting the pin himself. So it was a good showing for Marcus, too, though. So regardless of what happens next between Jay Bradley and Jamin Olivencia, Marcus is solidifying himself as a top contender for the heavyweight championship. For other results for the night, the dark match results, as well as, of course, my top 20s, any other breaking news. Don't forget you can check out ovwmania.blogspot.com. Got all kinds of great stuff up there. And I'm going to take a quick break, and when I come back, I'm going to talk about that TNA show and a couple other little tidbits, so stick with us. Okay, so that commercial you just saw was for Saturday Night Special. The next one comes up August 3rd, 2013. We already know that Jamin Olivencia defends the OVW Heavyweight Championship against Jay Bradley. Some other matches that I think could happen. Nothing else has been confirmed yet, but I think Trina might be defending the Women's Championship against Lady Tapa. I would say there's a chance we might see the OVW Southern Tag Team Champions, Ali and Michael Hayes, defend against some combination of the Marauders. And unless they split Bostic up and start having him feud with someone else for the OVW television title, I would say there's a chance that he could end up in like maybe a three-way match for the TV title that involves both Tony Gunn and Randy Royal. If not, I can see Bostic defending against whoever supposedly the number one contender is, and Gunn and Royal having some kind of brawl or no disqualification match, something along those lines. As far as TNA Impact Destination X, wow, it was a great night. First of all, I enjoyed the company of the Triple Threat Talk guys. It was a lot of fun being there with them. Plus, we saw all kinds of OVW people throughout the night, whether it was fans. The Assassin was actually there walking around with his mask on. Also beside two great fans, Nathan Karpinski and his son Chance, who we call Micro, which is a lot of fun hanging out with them too. We went out and ate at Steak and Shake after the show. If TNA did every show like they did the other night in Louisville, there's no telling how much better they could do in the ratings every week. I don't know if it was just the hot crowd. I don't know if it was being there live. But I thought it was one of the best shows they've had, not only this year, but in the last couple years. I haven't watched them that closely up until the last couple years when OVW had joined on as the developmental territory. But I thought this was a fantastic show. Everything from the X Division matches, especially the Ultimate X match, which hasn't actually aired yet. It was on the second taping, but the winners of the first three X Division matches on the first show, which was Manic, Greg Mariachulo, which was the former Trent Beretta, and who else was it? Sanjay Dutt, compete for the X Division title, and I thought that was an incredible match. The fact that they actually had Chris Sabin get the victory over Bully Ray, and he's your new TNA World Heavyweight Champion, was incredible in person. And I've said it before, I think TNA needs to figure out how they're going to do their finances and spending. But, I mean, there's nothing more loud and incredible as the reception, even in the age he is now, for Hulk Hogan live. You know, I found myself, you know, cheering and applauding. I mean, he's done a lot for wrestling. I just don't think that he needs to be in the ring. If he stays in the general manager role and doesn't take up too much time on Impact every week, I'm fine with that. But like I said, I still think TNA needs to keep investing in their young, up-and-coming talents, especially the X Division stars, because apparently that was one of the highest-rated Impacts in a long time. And with it, the first show being the Destination X and focusing on a lot of those guys, that kind of tells you something right there. So it was a fantastic show. I mean, the whole night, the crowd was loud, rowdy. Apparently it came through real well on TV too, from what I've heard from most people. I've seen comments here and there, but I think a lot of those comments are people who, regardless of what you say, or if you took them to a show and it was the very best show TNA's ever put on, I still think they would say, oh, I don't like it, just because they're either WWE fans or just like to poop on TNA. So there's some people I just don't think you'll ever win over. But I know that the other Triple Threat guys had said that they weren't expecting a lot going into it either, and I think they were all very impressed and really enjoyed the show as well. So it was a great night. I wish we would have saw some more OVW stars, but I know there was a lot of them backstage because we saw them come out after the show. And I think there's a chance we might be seeing some of them very soon in the future getting a chance on TNA Impact Wrestling. So we can only hope. Don't forget to check out OVWrestling.com for some upcoming events besides their TV shows, the SNS coming up on August 3rd. They've got some other cool things coming up. I know they've got a homecoming coming up soon. They've got something they're going to start doing once a month called Old School, where they're going to do focus on more wrestling from like the 70s and 80s. Think, you know, back to like the USWA days down at the Louisville Gardens. And then they've also got a show coming up called No Holds Barred, where it's going to feature Danny Davis, Rip Rogers, Trailer Park Trash, Nick Densmore. They're just going to get in the ring and tell stories about their careers. Now, it is an 18 and over show because they said some things could get explicit, but it sounds interesting, you know, especially if you were fans back in the day and wanted to hear about what happened. I guess I'll talk about things that happened backstage, on the road, you know, probably some things just generally in life that don't even have to do with wrestling. So it could be kind of a cool event to be at. And finally, I would like to send thanks out to Terry Bode, because as always, each and every week, he's plugging my website. Chris Sharp is always retweeting and sharing things on Twitter and Facebook to help promote me helping promote OVW. And then, of course, a big thanks to the Triple Threat Talk guys, Big B, Postmaster Jones, and the Doctor, not only for allowing me to do these videos each and every week here on Triple Threat Talk, but just getting to hang out with them the other night was a lot of fun as well. We need to do that more often. We've been getting together occasionally for the WWE pay-per-views, but it was a lot of fun the other night, and thank you all very much for joining me. It was awesome. So I think that'll pretty much wrap it up for tonight. So we're going to send it back to the studio. Have a great night, and I'll see y'all again next week for episode 109. Because I think this is for episode 108 of Triple Threat Talk. Bye.